Hi, my name is Connor, and to get into kind of a festive spirit, I was wondering what it'd be like if I put my own twist on a Hallmark commercial. I was kind of curious, so this is my spin if I did a holiday commercial.
Hi guys, it's Kelly here, and I'm going to be talking about shows that have been recommended to me and that I've watched them and give you my feedback and whether or not you should watch them. And the one I'm going to talk about today is a series on Netflix called Evil. I've watched the entire thing in like 3 days. I think it's 13 episodes. It was super good. It's about this priest in training who hires a psychologist to evaluate whether or not these people are possessed and need an exorcism, or if they're actually just crazy. And the psychologist, this woman, she doesn't believe in devils and possession. She doesn't believe in any of it. But as the series goes on, like, more things start happening and she starts to believe.
True or false? I like mechanics magazines.
Are you serious? False.
I have diarrhea once or more a month.
False, but thanks for asking.
I like the sound of a woman screaming. Orson.
Ms. Bouchard, I work for the Catholic Church.
So you're a priest?
No, an assessor.
My colleague Ben and I investigate unexplained phenomena.
I didn't know that was a job.
It is.
I don't believe in all that. Devils and possession.
The problem with my job is that possession looks a lot like insanity, and I need someone to help me distinguish between the two.
This is what? A haunting?
Well, the theory is that the demon takes over the house, and then it takes over the person.
I know you believe in this stuff. I don't.
They're who do bad things and encourage others for the pleasure of it.
Psychopaths?
Yes. This is where our beliefs overlap.
It's just a dream.
Can a dream do this?
Take this. Trust me. You may need it.
Welcome to episode 2 of Kitty Girls Christmas Creations.
So today we're going to be making a peppermint Christmas tree.
I'll put a picture right here.
So the ingredients you need is a hot glue gun, these peppermints, and a styrofoam cone. So first you just put a little bit of glue on the back, and then you just place it right on there.
Oh yes.
And
then you repeat until your Christmas tree is done.
I'm gonna need another stick.
In a large bowl, you will put 3 sticks of butter and 2 cups of brown sugar and mix it up. Next, add 1/2 cup of molasses and keep mixing. After the molasses, add 2 eggs and mix it up again. In a separate bowl, you will put 2 1/2 cups of flour, 1 tablespoon of baking soda, 1 tablespoon of salt, 1 tablespoon of ginger, and 2 tablespoons of cinnamon. So you add them all together, stir it up. When it is all stirred up, add the dry mix to the other bowl and mix it up until it looks like this. Next, get a bowl of sugar, roll your cookie dough into little balls, and coat them in the sugar. Set your oven to 375 degrees. Put your cookies in the oven for 9 to 11 minutes. When they are done, take them out, let them cool, and enjoy.
Hi, I'm Lucy, and I'm here with my sister,
Elizabeth.
And today we're going to be baking
banana bread.
So if you have anything in your oven, you're going to want to take them all out, and then you're going to set the oven or whatever to 375 degrees, and then you wait. The water, the 1 cup of water, the 1/3 the 1/3 cup of oil, okay, and the 2 eggs. Make sure to not get any shells in it. Now we're gonna mix it all together. And when you have those combined, you gradually wanna mix in the actual mix into it. So this is what it looks like. You're gonna grease the pan where you wanna put it in. I'm gonna put in this small squared one. And you only wanna put a little bit to pour the mixture in it. So now that you put your mixture into your pan, you're gonna wanna put it in the oven safely. I recommend using an oven mitt very carefully. And then close it. Now I'm just gonna leave it baking for 15 to 20 minutes and keep on checking on it. Okay, so I'm not even gonna lie. This is not that good. It's not that amazing. It's not as amazing as I thought it would be. But it's not bad, it's just dry. And I think that's because I let it in there for too long, maybe. Yeah, that was baking with me.
Welcome back to Dice. We are reviewing Subway because we didn't want to cook anything. And we are gonna go over what we got.
How good it tastes.
We're gonna go over how good our sandwiches taste and what is inside.
I'll go first. I have a spicy Italian with pepper jack cheese, pepperoni, whatever meat that is, and mild pepper, aka the banana pepper.
What'd you call it?
All right, well, I have a spicy Italian, just a little bit different than Owen's. So pepperoni, salami, teriyaki chicken, lettuce and ranch. I love this thing.
I got a Frank's Red Hot Buffalo Chicken Ranch sandwich.
I'd give this an 8 out of 10, just because this is the main thing I get when I go to Subway.
I'd give mine a 9. No reason, it just feels like a 9.
For my first time having this, yeah, I'd say like a 7 or an 8. Definitely would get this again.
Alright, well, that's our food review on Subway.
Have a good Christmas break. Thank you for tuning in.
Yeah.